not a problem, I say label it. And so that is coming down the pike. It's a 2012 ballot initiative campaign to label GMOs, and I say support it.
The GMO labeling issue is on fire in the United States. Bills have been introduced in 19 states, although none have yet gotten past Monsanto's lobbying and influence peddling. In California, we have a real chance of victory because in California, it's a ballot initiative. People vote directly. So we finally have a chance to get what 9 out of 10 Americans have wanted for more than a decade, mandatory labeling of genetically engineered foods.
I have enough questions about this technology to wonder what's happening with us. We have studies that say everything's okay, that in the industry, an industry that I don't trust. We have studies by independent doctors that say there are huge questions and that there are problems. There have been no long-term human studies done on this, and I, as a grandmother and a mother, am outraged that our government and that our agencies are not taking care of this for us. They are not protecting us. We have a right to know what we're putting inside of our bodies.
The entire world is looking to California because we can turn it around from this one place. The enormity of the threat is unprecedented in history. All living beings, all future generations. So the enormity of the solution is something that we cannot afford to let slip away.
You know, if you like GMOs, you think they're great, okay, label it. You know, just be proud of it. Buy it, label it, and, you know, but we have a right not to buy it. So, you know, that's our issue. And we're taking that to Washington. You know, we got to bring outside pressure. We got to bring a wake-up call to FDA and, yeah, make our voices heard.
We're taking back the power to the people. We have people all over this state that are working nonstop in communities, 151 leaders that are organizing their communities, that are getting out there, they're educating their people. We understand what's going on now with government and with corporations.
Folks, this is what can happen when one very persistent, semi-obnoxious Italian grandmother from California decides that it will.
I just want these corrupt governments and corporations to leave my body alone, to leave my family alone, to leave my milk alone, my food alone, my family alone, my community alone. I can take care of myself. The whole world can take care of itself.
You want to know the dirty little secret of the biotech industry that they never talk about? No one gets up in the morning wanting to buy a GMO food. No one, not a single human being on earth, gets up and says, boy, I can't wait to go to the supermarket and buy a GMO food.
Right.
And why is that? That's because after 30 years and hundreds of billions of dollars of public and private investment, they haven't been able to come up with one thing in this food that actually helps the consumer. No better taste, no lower price, no more nutrition, nothing, zip, zero, nada.
How do we get rid of genetically engineered foods? It's much easier than you think. And we don't have to ask the government for a bailout. We can do it ourselves. In Europe, when they achieved the tipping point of consumer rejection at the end of April 1999, within about a week, most major food companies committed to stop using GM ingredients. They had become a marketing liability. In the United States, as parents became aware of the cancer link to bovine growth hormone, it was kicked out of most American dairies. How many Americans will it take avoiding GMOs to create a tipping point in the United States? We think only 5%. Why? If the same food companies that already kicked GMOs out in Europe see even a small drop in market share in the United States that they can directly attribute to anti-GMO sentiment on the rise here, they will get rid of it here like they already got rid of it in Europe. It becomes a food industry sell signal, getting rid of GMOs, and we can do it ourselves.
These companies are parasites. They don't care. They want to make money, they want to run governments, and they are right now running governments. I don't know how long, but I think their time is running out.
While you can't control what was produced yesterday, by what you spend today, you get to control what is produced tomorrow.
Moms and consumers are the ones that are going to make this change. They're going to be the ones who are going to drive the change. If we demand that products be safe and healthy for our children, if we refuse to purchase products that we know are genetically modified, then the industry is going to have to respond. Because at some point, you know, mothers are the ones that are out there buying 80% of the consumer products, including the food supplies and the cleaning supplies and whatnot. And if we stop supporting those companies that are doing this, then they're going to feel it in their pocketbook. And unfortunately, I think that's where it really matters to them.
A mother protecting her child is one of the most fundamental forces in nature, and most women would do anything to protect their child. And so to harness that power in a positive way is something that no one could mess with.
This impacts everything and everyone. It's not just an agriculture issue, it's not just a food industry issue, it's an ever-living creature issue.
It's the most dangerous thing facing human beings in our generation.
Should you be concerned? I should think you'd be scared silly, not only for your children, but for you. Why do you think so many people are sick now? We cannot tolerate what's going on any longer. We must stand up and be counted. We must write our politicians. We must talk to the people at the store and say, I'm not going to buy it unless it says not genetically engineered.
I think we now can change the system. The world is ready.
You know, sometimes we hear that Monsanto can't be beat, you know, that the genie's out of the bottle or the genes are out of the bottle. Well, that just is not true. In the last 15 years, you and me and all of us, we have defeated genetically engineered tomatoes. They don't exist. Genetically engineered potatoes, they tried that. We got rid of that. Genetically engineered wheat. That was Monsanto's big try. All the wheat in the world's been genetically engineered. We defeated that. Genetically engineered rice. We defeated that. Genetically engineered biopharmaceuticals. This is when they were going to put all those vaccines into your food. That was defeated. Genetically engineered alfalfa, which is going to destroy our organic dairy industry. For 6 years, we have stopped that, and we're right in court to stop it again right now. Genetically engineered bent grass in all your schools and golf courses. We've defeated that. So they can be beat, they have been beat, and we will win. We will win this.
It's in our hands. It's right in front of us. It's just a matter of avoiding genetically modified foods and inspiring others to do the same.
My new school, I'm going to try to get the GMOs away from there, too.
What are you going to do?
Just keep on telling them, and then they'll probably get it away.
What are you going to tell them?
Stop doing the GMOs and start doing the good food.